Welcome to Stern Effects. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to automatically vectorize video using the auto trace command in After Effects. Vectorization or tracing is the process of taking a bitmap image and redrawing it as a vector image. The vector shapes can be scaled to any size without loss of quality and have a distinctive look when you apply effects to them. In the first example, we'll take the first movie ever created by Edward Maybridge, who spelled his name with additional letters that I'm not sure if I should pronounce. But the more important thing is that Mr. Maybridge himself pronounced the movement of a horse by creating a series of cabinet cards back in 1877. It's also known as the Horse in Motion. And this is what we are celebrating today. However, the GIF animation that I found over at Wikipedia is a retouched version of this famous animation, and it's so tiny it doesn't have enough data to be used in this animated poster that I'm working on. So let's see how to enlarge and stylize it to fit the current size of an HD comp. So to save some time, I already started cleaning this animated GIF. I've applied the levels effect and crushed the input black and the input white. I also added the solid composite effect, which is using the default settings, and this will help us to fill the masked area on this layer. So if I press the letter M, we can see that I have four masks that I've applied to this layer, and this is just to help us clean the floor and hide some of the imperfections of this captured image. Now, because I've masked some areas, I need to fill the transparency holes, and this is why I've added the solid composite effect. And the reason is that the auto trace command will trace around everything it sees. So if you want to get a cleaner result, you should fill the areas that has transparency. Hopefully it will be clearer in a moment once we are going to see this command in work. So the auto trace command, which you can find under the layer menu, goes back many years ago to the days before shape layers or even text-to-mask conversion tools were existing in After Effects. It was used mainly to create masks based on the alpha threshold of a layer and offered few additional options to work on a channel-by-channel basis. More on that later, but now let's see how it works by default. So I'm going to switch it from alpha to luminance because this is what I want to analyze. I'm also going to move the dialog so I can see the preview over here. Notice that if I'll tick the preview option, After Effects is going to show me an outline of the masks that this command is going to create or actually trace. Now, by default, it is set to the current frame. I'm going to switch it to the work area. So it will analyze the entire thing, which is 1 second and 5 frames in this case. And we have some options. I'm going to return to those options in a moment, but I just want to show you what we are going to get by default. Very important, I'm going to also tick the apply to new layer. So once I'll click OK, after a few moments, After Effects is going to generate this result. Now, if I'm going to switch off the visibility, we can see that we actually got a negative version of what we need. So I'm going to undo and I'm going to reapply the command again. You need to select the layer and then go to layer auto trace. And this time I'm going to invert the result. I'll leave everything as is, make sure to apply the result to a new layer, and then I'll click OK. Then I'll switch off the visibility of the original one and I'm going to see just the desired silhouette of what I've created. Now, whatever you're going to do, I highly recommend to rename the layer. After Effects is going to add the name auto-traced to the name of the original layer, but I'm going to press return here, and I'm just going to delete almost everything, and then I'll add a dash, write down Luma, because this is what I've analyzed, and then invert. So if I need in the future to revisit this command, I'll know exactly what I did. All right, so I'll press spacebar to see this. And because this is basically using masks to express the same animation, and just to show it to you, I'll press the letter M. It's going to show us all the masks that were generated automatically. I'll press M again to close it. But since we are using masks, if I'll press the letter S this time to isolate the scale and scale this guy to, let's say, 250%, I can retain the vector quality. But this is not going to happen by default. You'll see that if I'll click outside, After Effects is just going to render a fuzzy image out of it. If we do want to tell After Effects to continuously rasterize the vectors, we'll need to check the sunshine or the continuously rasterized icon over here, and now we can see the final result. So this means that I can now scale it to any size I like. And just to show you one way to work with this, I'm going to return to the project panel. I'm also going to switch to the comp that I have over here. And if I press spacebar to preview this animation, you can see that I have few elements already looping in this composition. And I want to add the horse in motion, the hero, to the middle of this comp. So I'll return to the beginning. I'll grab the composition that I've just showed you, and I'll drag it underneath the adjustment layer. I'll switch it on in a moment. But as you can see, we have a problem. This is just too short to fit the entire duration. So to loop this composition, I'm going to go to the layer menu, and then under time, I'll enable time remapping. Then I'll go to the last keyframe over here. And as we can see, there's nothing there. This is the way After Effects is behaving with the time remapping option. Very annoying. So to remedy this, we'll need to move one frame backward by pressing page up, add another keyframe for the time remap option, and then I'm going to press plus a few times to zoom in, select the last keyframe, and press delete to remove it. Then I'll go to the beginning, and to loop this forever, I'll hold down the option here on the Mac, Alt on the Windows side, and click on the stopwatch, and I'll start to type the word loop. After Effects is going to offer me a few options. I'll select this one, loop out parentheses, double click, and click outside, and this is it. Now I can stretch the layer to reach the end of the composition, and if I'll press spacebar, we can see that it is going to loop forever. Now let's stylize it so it will look a little bit more in line with the other elements that we have. I'll pause the playback. I'll go to the effect menu, and this time under simulation, I'll add the CC ball action effect, which is going to turn this composition to a bunch of spheres. So before I'm going to change the grid spacing and the ball size, I just want to take away the shading here, and I'll do it by going again to the effect menu, and this time under generate, I'll apply the fill effect and I'll set it to white. Then I'll return to the CC ball action effect. I'll change the grid spacing to 4. I'll tab to the ball size and change it to 40. And now I have flat circles instead of spheres or balls. I'll go to the beginning and press spacebar just to show you what it looked like. And since this is such an iconic image, we can actually recognize that this is the horse in motion. Just to give it a little bit more life, I've also added this adjustment layer. I've named it Colors, I'll enable it, I've applied the Tritone effect, and I've mapped the highlights, midtones, and shadows to these teal colors. So I'll maximize the composition viewer and play the result for you. Now, if you have a few more moments to spare, I want to show you another example, this time using different channels from the video. And in this example, I'm going to return back to the project panel, double click on the makeup composition. We are looking at a clip from Adobe Stock. The link is in the description. And you can see a pretty girl applying mascara. And I want to make it more cartoony and stylize the video. So I will be able to scale it to any size I need, which can be very useful as a background for a music video, maybe even a music concert, whatever you want to do with it. I'm going to use the same technique that I showed you previously. So I'll pause the video. I'll select the layer, I'll go to the layer menu, and I'll return to the auto trace command. Now, this time, I'm going to change the channel from the luminance to the red. Again, I'll move the panel to the side so we can check the preview. The invert option is already checked, and this is what I want, but you can see that the masks are very harsh because this uses a threshold effect under the hood to trace the image. But you have the option to blur the result before the auto trace is going to commence. So I'll enable this and I'll start with a value of 10. And before I click OK, I'm going to just click somewhere over here and check the preview. And you can see that now I'm getting a nicer and smoother lines. Now you can also play with the other values, such as the tolerance threshold, the minimum area, and the corner radius. And if you're uncertain, make sure to apply the result every time to a new layer. Also, make sure that you are analyzing the entire work area and not just the single frame. And once ready, just click OK and let the tool do its magic. As before, I'm just going to immediately rename it to what I did. So red-invert. And in this case, I'm also going to give myself a clue that I've blurred it 10 pixels. I'm going to switch this layer off, return again to the original layer, and let's have another go with it. So I'll create another pass using the same menu, the same commands, but this time I'll try the blue channel, and we can see that we are going to get some different appearance over here. So I'll click OK, wait a few moments, and then, as before, I'm going to rename the layer. It takes a bit more time, but it will save you a lot of time in the future. Now, by default, the auto trace will always generate a white solid for you. So if you want to colorize it, you can add the fill effect. And in this case, let's just choose a blue color. So this is going to be this one. And for the red one, I'm going to hide the original video and show you that we have a background over here. So for the red one, I'm also going to add the same fill effect, but this time I'm going to change it to black and I'll switch the order. So the red is going to be on top of the blue and this is the result. I'm also going to enable a text layer that I've created ahead of time and press spacebar as well as maximize the composition and fit it to screen so we can see how this works. And this is it. This is my recipe to create stylized animated vector shapes from any video using the good old auto trace command in After Effects. I urge you to try it yourself and also explore other effect combinations with the auto trace command. So hopefully this was useful information, and if so, please like this video and subscribe to the channel. More exciting stuff is on the way. Thank you for watching and I'll see you again soon.